joined by the Director of Research and Chief Economist at the New Economics Foundation now, Alfie Sterling. Thank you for joining us, Alfie. How do you interpret the Chancellor's comments about hard choices everywhere?
Well, look, I mean, there's no question that we're facing really tough choices as a country, not least on public health, but also on the economy. But I think we've also got to be, we've got to be nuanced, and we've got to be intelligent about how we approach this, because at the moment, the government talks about non-viable jobs incredibly loosely. Now, we know that in 12 months' time, the economy will not be the same as it was 12 months ago. There are some jobs that we can protect in this intervening period and actually will be back in the economy in 9 months' time. For example, you know, I don't think anyone believes there will be no cinemas ever again. But there are also jobs where we know that you know, the composition of the economy is going to change. For example, we're not going to see as many people flying as we previously did. And there we do need to find a solution. But I would argue at the moment, the big problem with the government strategy is they've written off far too many jobs right across the economy, domestic tourism, hospitality, which we know are going to come back, but at the moment are not seeing the support they need.
Are tax rises inevitable?
I think so. The interesting thing here is I think tax rises will be needed in the UK, but that's not actually because we need to pay back any sort of debt or credit card that we've built up during this period. It's actually because we need to have stronger public services going forwards for two reasons. One is we've got an aging population. We're going to need to spend more on things like social care in order to maintain standards that we currently have. But we also know, and it's been exposed brutally, how if you underfund your public services for 10 years, you are incredibly poorly prepared for shocks like a pandemic. And there are other examples of crises that could be coming down the line as well, where if you haven't got strong resilience in your health systems, in your care systems, in your education system, you will fare worse than you would have done if with that steady investment. So yes, tax rises will need to come in the years ahead, but it's more about looking to the future, about strengthening our services rather than paying anything off.